24 years old. Hairline has been receding for 5 years. Am I a good candidate for a hair transplant? I'm 24 years old and my hair has been receding for the last 5 years. My hair is pretty thick everywhere else. Just the hairline keeps rising.
Thank you for your question. You're 24 years old and over the past 5 years, your hairline has been receding. And you're asking a very straightforward question. Are you a candidate for a hair transplant? Well, I'm going to discuss with you the approach that we have for patients like yourself at our practice, and I think that you're going to learn something that's going to be very different than what you've probably been researching up to this point as far as your options for a receding hairline. Just a little bit of history. For most hair transplant surgeons, with someone coming to them in the 20s, with this very aggressive recession, a lot of surgeons will choose not to operate because of significant limitations related to hair transplant surgery. See, the problem is that the amount of hair you're losing is far greater than the amount of hair available to restore all the hair that's being lost. So there's a limited area in the back of the scalp we call the donor area. And although lately it has been very popular to perform procedures called FUEs or follicular unit extractions, and there are all kinds of claims about mega sessions and the thousands of hairs being transferred, but the reality is the donor area is very limited. You look at the baldest man you can see you've ever seen, and then you'll understand that the genetically resistant area is very limited. And for someone in their 20s, if they do get a transplant, they're still receding. And then they need another transplant. Eventually, you run out of donor. In our practice, we've developed a method called hair regeneration. It is not surgery. It is actually an injection. Now, this method was developed combining a material called extracellular matrix derived from pig bladder and combining this with platelet-rich plasma. Now, what is extracellular matrix? This is a material that is used originally, was designed for wound healing. And what it does is it allows the duplication of cells native to a particular area. So if you apply it to muscle, you get muscle. If you apply it to skin, you get skin. What was noted is that when it was used to help assist in the healing of a donor area in the strips, for a strip method of hair loss for hair transplant, what happened was thinning hairs started to look thicker. So over the past several years, we have been developing a formulation and a delivery technique, and we call that hair regeneration. What this appears to do is it restores the cells and signals necessary to change the thinning process. Instead of hairs becoming thinner, hairs will reverse and become thicker. We always advise prospective patients that the sooner they get this done, the better it is, because we can save the hairs that are thinning, but we can't save the hairs that are gone. So this is something that is quite significant and has been very effective, and we've been helping patients who come to us from all over the world. So for someone in their 20s, I would actually advise against having a hair transplant and to consider hair regeneration. Of course, you also have the option for the two FDA-approved medications. One is minoxidil and the other is finasteride. Minoxidil does not reverse hair thinning, but appears to prolong the presence of hair that's thinning on the scalp. That makes the hair look a little bit thicker. Finasteride blocks an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase, which reduces dihydrotestosterone. Dihydrotestosterone, or DHT, can cause hair follicles that are susceptible to the effect of DHT to thin. So therefore, if you reduce DHT, in a certain segment of people with male pattern hair loss, you can get an improvement. What we have seen in our practice is that many people who are younger, who have this frontal receding type of progression, tend not to respond that well to finasteride. And lately, at this time, there is a lot of concern about the long-term sexual side effects of finasteride. I think the true impact of that has yet to be determined, but most of our patients who come to us in their 20s and 30s categorically do not want to take finasteride. So I want you to just now learn a little bit more about hair regeneration, learn about this process. Unfortunately, we don't have specifics as to the exact reason as to why this works. It appears that the basic science of hair growth has still yet to uncover all of the critical stem cells and the cells and signals necessary for hair growth, which is why hair cloning still remains elusive, and all of the biotechnology companies that have tried to corner the market on hair loss have not done very well, and their products don't seem to be doing very much. We have been successfully been able to use this material, which was already FDA approved for wound healing, and using it in an off-label way to treat hair loss. So it's a very exciting time, and it's been quite the game changer for people who have been coming to us from all over the world. So it's something to consider as an option for your situation. And so I wish you the best of luck. I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.